Justin Dunk reports that the province of British Columbia has not cleared the CFL return to play. Now, if you go read it at 3downnation.com, and I've had it sent to me like 40 times, and I appreciate it, guys, but to me, it isn't breaking news. We talked about it last week. BC's top doctor, Dr. Bonnie Henry, on March 5th said, by this summer, BC could be living a post-pandemic life. And everybody went nuts in BC, and a lot of CFL fans too. And then a week ago today, she said no large crowds in Vancouver till next winter. And that was met with crickets. Crickets. Nobody wants to hear that. So the point of Dunk's article was that, hey, if you watch the TSN draft on Tuesday night, David Naylor reported and Farhan Lalji confirmed or agreed that all six provinces with CFL teams have approved return to play protocols. And Justin Dunk reporting, no, they haven't. BC hasn't. The point of the article was more so that TSN was wrong or misleading. The news was not that I don't think that BC hasn't approved it. I mean, it was the news. You see where I'm going with this? So that's why everywhere I go, and I mean everywhere, it's CFL's playing August 5th, right? Like everywhere. On the straight, Lynch. And I'm just now, sure. I talked to Dunk this morning. I said, I'm tired of reporting this stuff because I'm starting to look like a negative troll. And I'm just reporting what I see, what's right in front of everybody's face. And it feels like the CFL leaders are trying to mislead you or distract you with the actual news. And I'm kind of out on it. I've been biting my tongue for the last few weeks on this. So where are you on what's this breaking news from Justin Dunk? Which it is, but the breaking news is that TSN told you otherwise. That's the news to me.
Yeah, we've all been misled before, right?
Yeah.
And when it's something that you want, and you're a CFL fan, we know John Lynch is the biggest Ryder fan of them all.
Yeah.
When you hear that, your brain triggers these things that blocks everything else out, and you only want to hear that they're coming back. So you're like, they're coming back. This is so exciting. They're coming back. It's like a parent when you're saying, well, are we going to go to Disneyland? We might go. We might. We're still thinking about it. We might go. The kid only hears, we're going to Disneyland, and starts telling everybody. And the parent's trying to let them down easy. You got to be realistic. Probably not playing. And this news from BC says, look, we're not all on the same page. There's a lot more work that needs to be done. So.
And Ontario's worse.
And Ontario's worse.
So I'm just like, what am I missing here?
And they've got three teams.
And by the way, a little furthermore, it's been reported for months, mostly by us and Dunk and Arash to a degree, that the CFL leaders can't agree on where to even go with this. Some want to keep the CFL as it is and add the Schooners if they can, but be damned with the XFL. Others want to go full-on merger with the XFL because that will save the league. And I did say to Dunk this morning, I just feel like they're going to fight themselves into the ground. I'm not telling any tales out of school here because I've been saying it on this show for months. And you had a good point about that, where the XFL fits into all this. I said, would you say this on the air? You said, absolutely, I'll say it.
Well, I mean, I don't think The Rock's coming to demolish the CFL, but it reminds me of like the ancient times, right? They're coming up to the gate, the XFL, to storm the castle. But then it's like, wait a second, guys, do you hear that? And meanwhile, they're fighting in the castle, killing each other. So the XFL can just sit back, let them kill each other, and then walk in, step over dead bodies, grab the gold, grab the food, grab all the supplies, and take over with no war at all, right? Mm-hmm. So it's like, look, in Canada, we got to stop fighting each other. And this includes the media, it includes the personnel, it includes players. Stop fighting each other about what matters, what doesn't, and let's start working together to save this thing, or at least send a note to the guys that are waiting at the outsides of the gate and say, here's a proposal, because we don't want to have a big war here. It's not going to be good for anybody.
Yeah, well, it sounds like they're at war, i.e. they can't agree, and the XFL is just going to walk in and pick up the pieces.
You're watching Rod Pedersen On Demand. For more of The Rod Pedersen Show, visit rodpedersen.com or follow Rod Pedersen on social media.